Hello, my name is Dr. Mailer, and welcome to Fun Science Demos Recommends. Today we're going to look at a wonderful site from NASA. NASA creates lots and lots of wonderful learning tools for science education, and this particular one is called the Solar System Exploration. The address for the Solar System Exploration is right here, and we're going to link this also in the description. What I'd like to do now, though, is I'm going to refresh this and show you on the landing page when we get here. So we're here right now, and as you'll notice, there are things like a moving solar system, different aspects of the solar system, planets, moons, asteroids, comets, some data down here, planets in our solar system 8, moons in our solar system 200. But what I'd like to show you today is right up here in this little spinning solar system. So we're going to click on that and explore what we see. So let's click on this little moving solar system here. And what you'll see is a real-time visualization of our 8 planets and the sun. That's our sun in the middle. Now, to give us a little more real estate here on this page, I'm going to click this and open it up to full screen so you can see this. We'll come back to this in a second. But let's take a look at this. Here's our sun. The first 4 planets, the inner planets, are here, Venus and Earth and Mercury. But it's hard to see them. We'll talk about them in a second. Jupiter here, Saturn here, Uranus, and Neptune. Many of you know that Pluto was reclassified as a dwarf planet, and I'd like to show you one of the reasons why that is. I'm going to click and hold this, and watch what happens as I move our solar system so that all 8 of the planets are lined up on this flat plane, which is called the ecliptic. You'll notice that Pluto doesn't line up, that it's on a pretty steep angle compared to the rest of the planets. That's one of the reasons why it was declared and declassified as a dwarf planet. Okay, let's go back to the full screen. I'm going to open this up, but this time I'm coming down here to the bottom. We're looking at the solar system now, but I'm going to move it to the inner solar system. So we're going to zoom in. So we zoom in, I click inner solar system, and now it's much clearer for us to see the first 4 planets. Here's the sun, here's Mercury, here's Venus, here's Earth, here's Mars. But also notice that we have other bodies around us. And what are they? Here's Eros. If I click on it, it'll tell me that this is an asteroid orbiting, and it was a spacecraft. One of our spacecraft had landed on it. So I'm just going to, so any body on here that you click on, you can get more information. But again, this visualization is so dramatic. I'm going to click it and drag it, and you'll notice that all of the planets line up on that flat plane, that imaginary flat plane called the ecliptic. There's so much to explore in this solar system exploration from NASA that I invite you to take a look at it. So I'm going to click this and just highlight a couple other things. So let's X out on this, and we'll show you our solar system. That's just where we are. We can investigate the sun, the Kuiper belt, the Oort cloud, beyond our solar system. We can look at specific planets. We can look at specific moons. This is just a wonderful visualization and a great learning tool for anybody that's interested in learning more about our solar system from the experts of our solar system, NASA. We'd really like to thank them for making this tremendous tool. Just a reminder that if you want to go and explore this on your own, that in the blue up there is the address that you can type in. And once you get to that landing page, take a look at that yellow arrow. That's what you want to click on. You want to click on that mini solar system. Remember, this is real-time data. This is where our planets are compared to each other in the solar system right now. Thanks for visiting Fun Science Demo Recommends. Check out our playlist for other really cool simulations and visualizations.